in heaven. Breakfast is 70 grams of Kodiak cakes, 5 grams of the I can't believe it's not butter, and then 20 grams of this syrup. I prefer this one over sugar-free syrup. I just think the totally sugar-free one is pretty artificial tasting, so I like this one, and I just used, you know, 20 grams or so, and 3 pieces of turkey bacon. Hello and welcome to the video. So today is Sunday, it is March 20th. You guys just saw my breakfast, so I figured I would take you guys through a full day of eating and kind of just like a day in the life, give you guys some updates on my life. So right now I'm just running some errands. I just finished up at Home Depot. I need to buy a new lock for my storage unit, which I figured I would just share with you guys some new and exciting things that are happening. So basically I'm going to start staging for homes that are for sale. So I do my online fitness coaching and I'm planning on continuing with that, and I do have some exciting things in the works, which I will share more on that later. But so yeah, I'm going to be kind of part-time also doing some home staging because I have such a huge passion for interior design. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know that I love interior design. I always have. I worked at a design center for a little while, and I'm just really excited about this next step. So my husband's a real estate agent too, so it kind of just like works hand in hand. I'll be staging homes that he has for sale, and then we have other family friends that real estate agents to kind of get started with that. So yeah, we bought a huge 30 by 12 storage unit, which I'll put some like clips over this or something, or some pictures or something to show you guys. This is our huge storage unit. It honestly doesn't look that big when I'm just recording it like this because there's so much stuff in it, but it is 30 feet by 12 feet, so it's literally giant, and it goes all the way back here. And we still have a bunch more furniture to put in here, so we need to get like some shelving units and stuff to organize this better, because it's kind of just a chaos right now. But I'm so excited to show you guys everything. We're still in the process of getting all of our furniture and kind of just getting everything started so that way we can actually start. So right now we're just kind of going through all the motions of creating a new business, right? Opening up a new LLC, really just finalizing everything. So been super, super busy, and I haven't shared anything about it yet. So I'm so excited to finally tell you guys. And in addition to that, my husband and I are buying a house. Not a house for ourselves. We're actually going to be flipping this house. So we've been, in the past we flipped a house. So my husband owned a house here out in San Diego, and we renovated it completely and sold it. So that was kind of like our first actual flip, but this is like our first like real one because we are buying the house solely just to flip it. So I'm super excited. I will share that whole process with you guys. We are in escrow right now and we're closing, I think in like a week and a half or so. So I can't wait. I will show you guys kind of like some before pictures and stuff in future videos, or like before walkthrough or whatever. And since I'll be sharing my life and just, you know, day-to-day things, that'll be part of it. So yeah, that's basically the news. That's what's been going on. A lot of big things have been happening behind the scenes. Excited to finally share that with you guys. So right now, like I said, I just finished up at Home Depot. I'm parked outside of Ulta because I need to go inside and get some new self-tanner. I'll share with you guys the self-tanner that I use. I really need to scrub off the self-tanner I currently have on and then redo it. And then I may run some errands and do some like other shopping here. I'm not totally sure. And then later I need to go, and I think I'm gonna go to a coffee shop to get a bunch of work done because I have a lot of client plans to write. So I figured I would just take you guys along for the day. All right, all this cost me $85 freaking, but this is the dry shampoo that I use. I normally order it on Amazon, but it said it was gonna take like a week and a half to get here, and I'm out, so I just got one for now. And then I also ordered them from Amazon, so I'll have them stocked up because they're definitely cheaper. And then this is the self tanner that I use. I use the express one, however, I will sleep in this. So I put this on at the very end of the night, and then I sleep in like a long sleeve shirt and long pants. That way I'm just not getting like self tanner everywhere, and I rinse it off in the morning. So even though it says 2-hour express, I like to keep it on the whole night because I feel like it just it gives better color and it lasts longer, but I really need to scrub off what I have on right now. And so I got some like exfoliating gloves and then this like exfoliating loofah. So I'm hoping that this will help to get off the like splotchy self-tanner that I really need to fix. So anyways, I thought I would share that with you guys. And now I'm heading home and gonna make up some lunch. Okay, so as you guys saw, I just made up some lunch. So I decided instead of having two fajitas, I'd make one into like a bowl. It just saves a little bit of carbs so I can have some more carbs for later. But basically I have just one of those tortillas then and 52 grams of corn, 54 grams of guacamole. I decided not to use the whole guacamole packet. That way I could just cut down a little bit on fat. Plus there's a lot in there. And then 4 ounces of cooked chicken and some salsa. This is seriously one of my favorite meals as of lately. I have this pretty much every single day. All right, so I'm gonna have one of these as a snack. I always like something sweet after my meals, and these are so good. The macros are really good too. Only 60 calories, 3 fat, 10 carbs, 1 protein. So highly, highly recommend. All right, it is now 5:30. I've just been busy working on my computer for several hours, so haven't really talked to you guys too much yet. But I just made up, I guess this is kind of dinner or like an early dinner, and I'm having 20 grams of these popcorn chips. These are seriously my favorite. I showed them in my grocery haul video. And then I'm using one of these sandwich thins, which the macros on these are super good. It's only 28 carbs, 1.5 fat, and 6 grams of protein. And I've got 2.5 ounces of cooked chicken. And then I'm using a little bit of this light mayo and this no sugar added barbecue sauce. Macros are super good on here. Only 4 grams of carbs for 2 tablespoons, and that's not even 2 tablespoons. And then a pickle, and these are the best pickles. I don't care what you say, these are the best pickles. So yeah, this has been another one of my staple meals. Okay, so it's now 8:40, and I just made, I guess, like a second dinner. Basically my last meal, and I'm just gonna have like a nighttime snack after this, but this is such a random combination. I made 2 pieces of this toast. Macros on this is so good. It's 18 carbs for 2 of them. And then 2 pieces of turkey bacon. I honestly didn't have that much protein left, so 2 pieces of turkey bacon just worked out perfectly. And then carrots and some green beans. And then I put a little bit of this, I can't believe it's not butter, on the toast. All right, so I'm gonna end my night with 2 of these dark chocolate Hershey Kisses. These are super good because macros are really good. Like one of them is around like 20 calories or so. So if you just have like 1 or 2 of these after a meal, it's really good because they like satisfy a sweet craving. And like I said earlier, I'm all about having something sweet after I eat a meal. And then I'm finishing off with one of these mini hold the cone ice cream cones from Trader Joe's. Macros are 280 for 3 cones, but I'm just gonna have one. They are pretty small, but they still are really good, and it's like 90 calories for one of them. So that will be the end of my macros for today. All right, you guys, it is now several days later, but I realized I never ended the video. So I wanted to say thank you guys so much for watching. I know that this is a little bit shorter of a video, but I wanted to take you guys through a full day of eating and kind of just a day in my life. I know I didn't share too much, but honestly, I mainly just was working on client plans all day. And then just doing some miscellaneous things around the house, like laundry and cleaning and all of that stuff. But I did want to mention something about my food and kind of just the food choices that I'm making. So as you guys can see, I do eat some processed foods, but I also do eat some more whole foods. Whole foods meaning things that don't really have a nutrition fact label. So that's gonna be like your vegetables and your meats and potatoes, rice, things like that. So I do flexible dieting, and I incorporate having balance within my diet. So I'm not on a meal plan or anything like that. I'm free to make my own decisions in terms of the food that I eat. However, I'm not going to fill all my macros with like cookies and candy, but I do allow myself to have treats here and there because that's just what works for me. If I was on a restrictive meal plan, I know I would not be able to I'd be able to probably adhere to it, but I would hate my life afterwards. I hate my life during it. And it just leads to a negative relationship with food. So find what works best for you. But for me, that is flexible dieting and being able to incorporate foods that I love still in my diet. And this is something that I do with my clients as well. So just wanted to share a little bit on that, but I will continue to do more full day of eating videos so you guys can see more of some of the food I eat. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to sit down and record a prep update video now for the next one. So if you're not already subscribed, make sure that you do, and that video will be coming out soon.